Now, definitely one of those what the hell took them so long stories. The collapse of a whole stack of large financial companies has left plenty of carnage. Life savings lost, families destroyed. Well, now the national corporate watchdog is going undercover to weed out dodgy financial advisors and protect, in particular, retirees. Eddie Meyer's been looking at the plan.
Les and Audrey McConnell should be living on Easy Street. Nearing retirement, they sold their house, bought a caravan and car to travel, and invested the rest with Storm Financial to build a nest egg. They trusted the advice and invested $350,000 before it collapsed.
We lost a lot. We come out with nothing.
These pensioners are now forced to live in their caravan.
As we're getting older, you realise there's nowhere to go. No. Got no money to go in a retirement village. That's it. We're finished. Life's over.
But major financial crashes aside, the industry is littered with victims. Brian Taylor is smart, considered and careful. He went to a reputable firm of financial advisors just to ensure his retirement funds stayed ahead of inflation.
I have to admit, I really feel quite bitter about the experience and what's happened. I lost all the earnings that I'd made in the first year. Then it started to eat into the capital.
When Brian eventually withdrew his investment, he thought he'd broken even, but his initial $800,000 was slammed by nearly $73,000 in fees and a $35,000 tax bill he didn't expect. Total loss, $108,000. The fees were way beyond estimates disclosed at the start.
And these fees, as I found out, are not related at all or in any way to the performance of the organisation.
The corporate regulator ASIC has been under fire for not being vigilant enough, but as more of us than ever march towards retirement, it's acting to weed out bad advisors.
The worst of them are the cases we see, which are absolutely heartbreaking, where somebody has been advised to put all of their money into a single investment and that investment's crashed and they've lost everything.
It's going undercover to target financial planners, using 80 regular retiring consumers to test the advice and ensure they're not being sold inappropriate investments.
We're going to simulate real life so we really see what the experience is like for consumers, what they understand, what they don't understand, how the advice they get matches their needs as they would describe them.
Planners say ASIC surveillance is welcome, but the industry is cleaning up its act anyway.
We're obviously delighted that in the initial release that this is not a name and shame process. This is actually about trying to improve the standards of the industry.
This is not the first time ASIC's gone undercover, and past poor results have forced the government to act. It's now proposing reforms to wipe out the worst practices, ban trailing commissions, and ensure advisors always act in the best interests of their clients.
The regulator has also launched a new website, moneysmart.gov.au. Better informed consumers, it says, are harder to rip off.
Go ASIC.